Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to talk about what is the data clustering. This is the third video from Snowflake Table Structures playlist. What is data clustering? Data stored in tables is sorted or ordered along natural dimensions. Here natural dimension is nothing but in your table, if you have a date columns, geographic regions, or country codes or state codes like that. This clustering is a key factor in queries because table data that is not sorted or is only partially sorted may impact query performance, particularly on very large table. So suppose if you have a very large table and the data is not sorted or partially sorted, then we'll go for the R clustering keys. Clustering is a key factor. As you know that in Snowflake, as data is inserted or loaded into a table, clustering metadata is collected and recorded for each micro partition created during the process. So this, you know, cluster metadata will be collected and recorded for each micro partition created during the process. Snowflake then leverages this clustering information to avoid unnecessary scanning of micro partitions during querying, significantly accelerating the performance of the queries that reference these columns. So basically, what does it mean? So what does it mean? Snowflake leverages this clustering information to avoid the unnecessary scanning. Suppose if in a table there are 100 partitions are there. Out of 100 partitions, when you try to retrieve the data from the table by using the one of the filter condition, which would be a part of your key, then you know it may scan only one or two partitions. By doing so, your query performance will be increasing. So that is what clustering information maintained for the micro partitions. So Snowflake maintains the clustering metadata for the micro partitions in a table, including. So the moment when you create a cluster to table, then Snowflake is going to maintain the following data for that micro partitions which are present in table. So the total number of micro partitions that comprise the table, the number of micro partitions containing the values that overlap with each other. So this is the another information, and the depth of the overlapping micro partitions. If you have any data overlap in your table, micro partitions, then the depth of overlapping micro partitions also will be maintained. We will see the what is the overlapping and depth. The clustering depth for populated table measures the average depth. So here, one or greater of the overlapping micro partitions per specified columns in a table. So if you have a clustering depth one or greater than, if there is a overlap, the smaller the average depth, the smaller the average depth, the better clustered the table is with regard to the specified columns. So suppose if you depth have a 5, then there still would be need to recluster or something like that. So if depth is 1, that means the cluster, your table looks good by using the clustering key. See, clustering depth can be used for variety of purposes, including monitoring the clustering health of the large table, particularly over time as DML is performed on the table. So this clustering depth can be used for the variety of purpose. One of that, when you're going to perform any DML, DML operations, then the cluster, by using the clustering, Snowflake will monitor the health of that cluster, determining whether a large table would be benefited from explicitly defining a cluster key. So this clustering also will monitor, Snowflake itself will monitor if you are going to create a, assume that you have created a clustering, and then is really, are you going to benefit the, by using that cluster or not? That information also will Snowflake will take care of that one. Okay, a table with no micro partitions, that is unpopulated or empty table, has a cluster depth of 0. That means, see, the moment when you create a table and inserted, and that table having the data, that means there are micro partitions are there. If table is empty or you just created the table, then in that case no micro partitions. If you don't have micro partition, the clustering depth of that table would be 0. That is what this point is saying. So now we'll see the cluster depth illustrated by with this diagram. This diagram I have copied from Snowflake document. Here we assume that we micro partitions total equal to 5. See, here total micro partitions are 5, and overlapping micro partitions and overlap depth, we'll see. In the first, if you see here, there are total values are storing to A to Z in 5 partitions. This is the one partition, this is the another partition, this is the another partition, this is the fourth, and this is the fifth. So we have total 5 micro partitions are there. So here all A to Z values are stored in all the partitions. That's why here overlapping micro partitions are 5. So data has been overlapped all the partitions. So overlapping micro partitions 5, and depth of overlap depth is 5. Now coming to this here, after assume that you might have created some cluster, and then data has been reclustered on this table. So after this, if you see, A to D values are stored in the single cluster, and D to J values are stored in the another cluster, and K to Z values are overlapped in the three clusters. So total here we have a partitions 3 only, 1, 2, and this is the one partition. Okay, so overlapped. So here overlapped means here the number of partitions 3, and overlap depth is 3, because these are the 3 values. Now after, assume that again you might have changed your cluster key. After that, changing the cluster key, assume that again the data, recluster happened. In that case, if you see here, the number of partitions still here, overlapping micro partitions are still 3. However, here you can see depth is only 2 because of the data, how that has been distributed. Like that, if you see here in the last example, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, here overlap micro partitions are 0. That means here the data A to Z are stored in one micro partition, E to J one micro partition, K to N another micro partition, O to S one micro partition, and T to Z another partition. So there is no overlapping. So that means the overlapping micro partitions are 0, and the overlap depth is 1. If there is no overlap depth, as I said that if we have a micro partitions to a table, the depth would be 1 only. Okay, if table is empty, then only overlap depth would be 0. That is all about clustering depth. Thanks for watching my video, and if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and like it and share it to your friends.